Hi students, how are you? Welcome to the online classes. K. Varalakshmi, Social CRT, KCB Vithada, Nellore district.
Before starting today's section, children, once again we will discuss about previous class. Listen carefully, children. In previous class, we discussed about the 8th class first lesson, reading and analysis of maps. In our previous class, we have discussed about earliest maps, that are Sumerian maps, Babylonian maps, and also we discuss about British maps. Once again, we will recall the last class, children. Already in the last class, we learn about map and photograph. What is the differences between map and photograph, children? Map doesn't show real features. Photograph show real features. Map is used by geographers to show features that we consider important. Examples: population, soil types, languages, crops, rainfall, etc. Photograph does not give abstract details such as measurements. So, we will go to another topic, Sumerians. Sumerians. This is the Sumerian clay tablet, children. Sumerians was the first peoples who drawn the clay tablets. Sumerian was about 4000 years ago. They were imprinted on clay tablets. Where are Sumerians present, children? Sumerians was present in Iraq. Students, now we will go to the Babylonians. This is the Babylonian clay tablet. Babylonians was the first people who drawn on the old maps. Babylonians drawn old maps on clay tablets in 2600 years ago. Students, who are the three Greek geographers? The three Greek geographers are Anaximander, Hecateus, Herodotus. They divided the world into three continents, that are Europe, Africa, and Asia. Children, in last class, we learn about longitudes and latitudes. What is longitude? The longitudes are horizontal towards North Pole to South Pole. What is latitude? The latitudes are parallel and they are passing through the equator. Students, who is the great Greek king? The great Greek king is Alexander. Children, now we discuss about the another Greek geographer, Ptolemy. One of the most geographer of the ancient world. Ptolemy prepared detailed maps of the world using these lines, latitudes and longitudes. You know, students, Al-Idrisi was one of the famous Arab map maker. Al-Idrisi prepared old maps for his king in 1154. Al-Idrisi map shows, firstly, it shows south towards the top of the map, north towards the bottom of the map. You know, students, the China emperor name is Daming Han Yitu. See the map of Daming Han Yitu painted on 17 square meters of silk in 1389 for the Emperor of China. Students, we will discuss about today class. Today, the topic is model of the world according to the Bible. Before, they discovered the books of Ptolemy. European was map makers. Ptolemy influenced by religious ideas of the Bible. See the map, students. What is this map? It is the model of the world according to the Bible. It is surrounded by oceans and it is divided into three continents: Asia, Europe and Africa. Asia was considered the largest and most important continent because in Asia there is Jerusalem, which was the birthplace of Jesus Christ. Around 1480s, Europeans rediscovered the Ptolemy's books. They were stunned to learn about his accurate description of location of places. They prepared new maps based on them. Students, now we will discuss about map based on mathematical calculations prepared after reading the books of Ptolemy. See the map, students. Unlike the map shown above, this is based on actual mathematical calculations of distance and directions. Students, in the 15th century, Ptolemy inspired a new enthusiasm in the non-Arabic world. So many countries, persons were interested to make maps. Who were inspired by the Ptolemy? These all the people were inspired by the Ptolemy, and the most countries were very interested to make maps. Ptolemy books, for example, the Italian school, the French school, the British school, the German school, the Dutch school. In the 15th century, where the world was very busy to make accurate maps at that time, it was the discovery. Fortunately, it happened to be an age of discovery and exploration, which popularized map and its importance. The Arab had blocked the trade route to India across the Mediterranean Sea. Turkey king was blocked this route. Hence, the Europeans searching the sea routes to India, Africa, North America, South America. Note on the small assignment, children. First question: who is the famous Arab map maker? Second question: who is the Chinese emperor? Third question: where was Jesus Christ born? Who were inspired by the Ptolemy books? Students, who is this person? He is Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama, Portuguese navigator and explorer, becomes the first European to reach India via the Atlantic Ocean. When he arrives at Calicut on the Malabar coast. So, finally, Vasco da Gama, 1498, discovered to sea route India. Next, I will tell about a person. Here, I am showing the person. Who is that person? He is Christopher Columbus. Columbus was an Italian explorer and navigator who completed 4 voyages across the Atlantic Ocean, opening the way for the widespread European exploration and colonization of the Americas. It is commonly said that Columbus discovered America. It would be more accurate, perhaps, to say that he introduced the Americas to Western Europe. During his 4 voyages to the region between 1492 and 1502, students, we will discuss the 16th century. In the 16th century, all the countries are busy to establish its power in the different countries. For example, British, they established that political powers in our India. They came to India 1608. 1608, they came, let many countries, like Dutch, we are calling it as Holland. Dutch was a very great country in 16th century. It was a major trading country. With the rise of Holland's maritime supremacy and trade. Note down the small assignment, children. First question. Prepare a few questions to know about different types of maps. Second question. Who is a Vasco da Gama? Third question. When Vasco da Gama discovered the sea route of India? Students, who is the person? The father of Dutch cartography was Gerardus Mercator. Gerardus Mercator, 1512 to 1594. He was introduced a projection. He was introduced a new method to identify, to locate the places. Mercator's map projection is famously known Mercator projection. Mercator projection is a type of map projection. Most of the old maps we use are based on his projection. This Mercator projection is still used to show the world. Students, observe this map. Old map by Gerardus Mercator in the 16th century. Students, now we will discuss about projection in a map. What is projection? Projection is a forecast based present trends. Projection means in cartography, systematic representation on a flat surface, curved surface as that of the earth. Students, as you know, the world is like a ball. But when we draw it on a paper, we cannot show the curvature and have to show it as flat. This inevitably causes some distortion, either the shape of the continents and the distances will get distorted, things will get placed in wrong directions. Now we will discuss about colonization, explorations, military use and map making. Students, when European powers colonized the entire continents are like North America and South America, Africa, Australia and Asia. Okay, they needed to know about the places, their climate, crops, mineral resources. They sent scientific expeditions consisting of map makers. They explore the different part of the world and they prepare maps. Students, they are crossing mountains, deserts and rivers. When the British established their power in India, they began making detailed maps of the interiors of the country. British established a department called Survey of India. Students, who is this person in the above photo? He is James Rennell. James Rennell was appointed the Surveyor General and he prepared one of the first survey based maps of India. Students, look at the map of India that was created during the British period and compare it with a current map. Students, you think who is the person in this photo? He is William Lambton. In 1802, William Lambton began one of the most important geographical survey in the world. See the photo, students. The person name is George Everest. The survey was completed by Sir George Everest. It is the survey which established that Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. You know, student, Everest peak height 8,848 meters. The survey began in Chennai because all heights are measured from the sea level. Maps were also in great demand during the times of war as armies and air forces. Many governments tried to keep such detailed map secrets so that enemies could not use them. However, in our own times, the use of satellite imagery has transformed the nature of mapping. We not only have very accurate and detailed maps, but it is no longer possible for the governments to keep them as secrets. This information is available to all people for study and use today. Okay, children? Note down the small assignment, children. Assignment 3. First question: what is a projection? Second question: who is the father of Dutch cartography? Third question: who established the survey of India? Fourth question: why do you think the colonial power invested so much money to prepare detailed maps? Fifth question: who discovered America? Now we will discuss about use of maps in our times. In our own times, maps are used for planning and development of countries. This is done with the help of maps. For example, we can make a map of regions which have very little drinking water. We can compare this map with maps showing water resources like rainfall, groundwater, and rivers. Based on this comparison, we can decide what is the best way to make drinking water available. We can plan agriculture development, setting up new industries, buildings, roads, hospitals, and schools with the help of maps. Maps are also used by companies to plan their business work. For example, a mobile telephone company that wants to spread its network in an area. Area will need maps of villages and towns and about hills and forests to set up microwave towers. Now we will discuss about thematic maps. What is thematic maps? Thematic maps focuses on one aspect. These maps are used to show distribution of specific features such as land use, temperature, rainfall, population, soils, natural vegetation, crops, minerals, industries, railways, roads, waterways, etc. A thematic map is a type of map that portrays the geographic pattern of a particular subject matter in a geographic area. This usually involves the use of map symbols to visualize of geographic features that are not naturally visible, such as temperature, language or population, nature, the terrain, economic activities of the people. Usually, a map focuses on only one aspect of such maps are called thematic maps. For example, political maps, which give information about mandals, districts, states, capitals, etc. Physical maps, which shows mountains, rivers, plateaus, etc. Land use maps, which show how people use land. For example, some parts of village land may be used for raising crops like cotton. To find out the places and location on maps, we use different kinds of symbols, colors and pattern to show each of these separately. Students, now we will discuss about color, land cover, land use. Colors, dark green color, most usually it was used for the forest, that is indicating forest. Light green color indicate completely grasslands. Brown color usually indicates land useful for agriculture. Yellow color, it is especially used for the plateaus, swampy area. Dark gray color, it was used to indicate the mountain. Light gray color, it is especially used for the hills. Light red color, it was usually used for the wasteland and useless land, that lands were not useful. Light blue color, mostly used for the rivers, tanks, ponds, canals, etc. Dark blue color, it is used for seas and oceans. White color, usually used for the places of minerals. Black color, it will be used for the boundaries. Okay students, note down the small assignment children. First question, what is a thematic map? Second question, what are the various purposes for which maps are used in our times? Third question, prepare a few questions to know about different types of maps. Fourth question, which indicates tanks, canals, wells, rivers? I will ask some questions to you children. Who were the Portuguese explorers? Magellan, Vasco da Gama were the Portuguese explorers. What is satellite imagery? Satellite imageries are the photographs of the earth taken by the artificial satellites launched into the space. Who made his first voyage around the world? Ferdinand Magellan made his first voyage around the world. What is a projection? Projection is a forecast based on present trends. Who is the father of Dutch cartography? Father of Dutch cartography, Gerardus Mercator. What is a thematic map. Thematic map is a focuses on one aspect. Which color indicate dark green? Dark green indicate forest. Study the above map carefully and answer the following questions. Children, remaining part of the lesson we will discuss in the next class.